Philippine stocks managed to post some modest gains on Tuesday as investors digested inflation data, which eased to four-month lows, although still above government's target range. Meanwhile, unemployment also eased to 7.4% in October, though still translating to 3.5 million jobless Filipinos. UAP's Professor Vic Abola believes inflation may have peaked already. He also doesn't see the Omicron variant greatly hurting growth prospects for next year.
I don't believe it's going to be very disruptive, as like the Delta variant. We've seen, I think, the worst type of variant. And if we follow the normal pattern of viruses, the mutant mutation results in more contagious but less deadly mutations. Full year this year will be, I think, fall short of the 6%. I think it's about 5.8%, my projections for this year. And for next year, it goes up to 6.5%. It could be higher, but that depends very much on the second half, because what you know, but there's an uncertainty there because the president or the new administration may not have funds to continue the momentum.
For the day, the PSE index added 0.25% to close at 71.47. HSBC's equity strategist for ASEAN and frontier markets, Devendra Joshi, says there's plenty of upside in Philippine stocks.
Philippines, yes, it's under-owned by foreigners. The valuations are still attractive. I think it's trading at around 10% discount to five-year average price to book. Some of the other markets are trading at, in fact, at par or maybe some at premium in terms of emerging market space. Across Asia, the inflation is not an issue. It's more of an issue in the US and some of the other markets, but not in Asia. And within Asia as well, maybe for some markets, headline CPI might have budged up, but the core inflation has barely budged. Similarly, in Philippines, fall into that category that we did see headline CPI rising, but that was more on the basis of supply side issues because of the typhoon-related disruptions. Asian central banks are not in that kind of hurry to raise rates as probably in some other parts of the world.
He adds Vietnam and Bangladesh are new markets gaining a lot of attention due to liquidity. In corporate stories, the newest member of the exchange, medical equipment distributor Medilines, owned by the brother of Manny Villar, saw its share price fall 30% at its debut. The company raised some 1.9 billion pesos from the exercise. And Price Corporation, known for its LPG business, is planning to spin off its Memorial Park business to unlock value and achieve sharper business focus. The company also in search of a potential solar firm that will help power its land bank properties. Looking ahead, there will be no trading on Wednesday, a special non-working holiday to commemorate the Feast of the Immaculate Conception of Mary. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.